Now listen here. If A equal to 1, 2, B equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, C equal to 5, 6, D equal to 5, 6, 7, 8, then state which of the following statement is true. So this is the cross product, isn't it? This is, you see the symbols, proper subset. This is a proper subset. You have studied about proper subset and improper subset, isn't it? For every set, empty set and given set are the two sets is there, other than the sets. So, this given set, suppose A equal to 1, 2. How will you write the subsets? Empty set, then the given set, then 1, then 2. These are the subsets of A. The given set is a subset. It is also a subset for the given set. Same set. This is called improper subset. This is called improper subset. Other sets, proper subsets. Do you follow? So the elements what it is present is either empty or less than the given number of elements. So, these are all proper subsets. Now, they are asking whether A cross C is proper subset of B cross D. B cross D is the proper subset of A cross C. Similarly, these two. First, for better understanding, you write the elements like this. Actually, by seeing the question itself, you will be able to say, but better you write A cross C. First smaller set I am writing. Next B equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Then D equal to 5, 6, 7, 8. Just you see the number of elements. Already you know about the cross product. That is N of A equal to P. N of B equal to Q, then N of A cross B equal to P into Q. Do you follow? So, what is the N of A cross C is what? 2 2s are 4. Next, N of B cross D is equal to what? 4 4s are 16. Now, by seeing the cardinal number, you will be say that A cross C is the subset of B cross D. So, this can't be correct. This cannot be correct because B cross D is bigger. Next, A cross B and A cross D. Isn't it? A cross B and A cross D. 2 4s are 8, 2 4s are 8. Both are same. Isn't it? But you have to check the elements. So, that is also, it is doubtful. Next, A cross D. That is D cross A and B cross A. Do you follow? D cross A and B cross A. This is also 2 4s are 8, 2 4s are 8. So, with the help of cardinal number, you won't be able to find it out. Here, by cardinal number you have checked. But, with the help of ordered pair, whether it is correct or not. Now, you see the set. A is the proper subset of B. And C is the proper subset of D. Then, automatically A cross C is the proper subset of B cross D. Isn't it? A is the proper subset of B and C is the proper subset of D. Then automatically A cross C is the proper subset of B cross D. Just you see the pair while you are taking the cross product. A cross C. A cross C. A cross C is equal to what? Just for verification I am saying. So this is the answer. But after checking the pair, it is better to do. 1, 5. 1, 6. Next to 2, 5. 2, 6. 4 pairs are there. Here is it possible or not? Very well. You see? 1,5. 1,6. 2,5. 2,6. Isn't it? Other than this, some more pairs are there. Isn't it? Other than this, 3,5, 3,6. But many pairs are there. 1,5. 1,6. 1,7. 1,8. Similarly, 2,5. 2,6. 2,7. 2,8. Next, 3,5. 3,6. 3,7. 3,8. Next, 4,5. 4,6. 4,7. 4,8. Isn't it? But what are the pairs you want? Just let me select the color. What are the pairs you want? 1,5, 1,5, 1,6, 1,6, 2,5, 2,5, 2,6, 2,6. All these fours are here. So A cross C is the proper subset of B cross D. Do you follow? So no need to find out this ordered pairs and all. By seeing the sets itself, you will be able to find out the answer. You see, here 1,2 is there, here also 1,2 is there. So 5,6 is there, here 5,6 is there. Isn't it? So this is the correct answer. Not at all necessary to find out all these things. With the help of the cardinal number, first you check. Afterwards, just you see the pair. No need to write these checks. For the late bloomer's purpose, I wrote the ordered pairs and checked it. But by seeing this orally, you can find out the answer. Do you follow?